Anyone who travels to Vietnam is thinking about sailing through the world's famous Ha Long Bay, as everyone is referring of Vietnam's biggest highlight. But you can also hear and read about too many boats with mass tourism that had reached gigantic proportions. We could then see with our own eyes that one ship lined up with the next. For this reason, we looked for a quieter and better alternative for us and end up on the island of Cat Ba. From here, a boat tour starts a bit more relaxed, and the 345 square kilometer large island is also offering a few sights. The highlight on the island of Cat Ba is probably the large national park, which covers a third of the entire island. A hike leads steep steps up the mountains to the summit. You will be rewarded with a green, fantastic view over the island. Trung Trang Cave is about 1 kilometer before the park entrance. The entrance ticket of the national park is also valid for the cave. A 300 meter long path leads through the Trung Trang Cave, where you can see the various forms of illuminated stalactites and stalagmites. But that's not why you go to Ha Long Bay. It's more of a boat trip to see the huge limestone cliffs, beautiful beaches, large caves and the green water in the world famous bay. Around 10 a.m. we boarded the Cat Ba Venture ship, and on the first day we sailed from Cat Ba City through Lang Ha Bay. Along mangroves, floating villages, paddling through caves to get to the lagoons, before we spent the night in Ha Long Bay. Basically, Lang Ha Bay offers everything that Ha Long Bay has to offer, just nicer. Nicer because you can still admire the UNESCO World Heritage Site alone without the many other Ha Long visitors. According to the official information, the around 1969 mostly unoccupied limestone cliffs and rocks are poked out of the water several hundred meters high. The limestone plateau that is home to the bay is slowly sinking. Unfortunately, the sun only came out from behind the thick clouds in the afternoon and enveloped the green rock cones in a wonderful island world. Here on the edge of Ha Long Bay, we were no longer alone and we could imagine how touristy it can be during the day. After a quiet night, we returned to Cat Bar City on the second day. However, after 1 hour, we anchored again to visit the floating fishing village and explored an isolated cave and lagoon again by kayak. Even if we went back the same way, the gigantic rock formations and mangrove forests looked different than the day before. After breakfast, we climbed into the kayaks again and explored the sidearms of Halong Bay, so we could watch black giant squirrels in the tree of a lagoon. Their home range extends from northern Nepal and southern China to Vietnam. They weigh about 1.5 kilo and have an average length of 80 centimeter. Unlike many squirrels, the black giant squirrels have no tail that curls over the backs. Instead, their tails lie limp behind them. Again and again, we passed fish farms that have often joined together to form floating fishing villages. People mainly live on wooden rafts that are made to swim with tires and plastic canisters. They live from fish farming and marine aquacultures. We really enjoyed the 2 days here in Lang Ha Bay and Halong Bay. Even if the weather in the morning was more typical of the region, the afternoon was more beautiful than expected. From Cat Ba, we then took the bus to Ninh Binh, or more precisely to Tam Coc in the dry Halong Bay. Subscribe to me if you want to see how it goes on. I'm also pleasant with a thumb up.